We appreciate your understanding and cooperation as we aim to make this a memorable occasion. Thank you for your attention. Please rise in the honor of Greenwood High School class of 2020-2021 and for the presentation of colors.
Ladies and gentlemen, in honor of our graduates, we request everyone please turn off their cell phones at this time, and please do not use air horns or do anything that will disturb the dignity of this event. Please remain standing for the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Good afternoon, Greenwood faculty and staff, friends and family, and most importantly, my fellow graduates. Today is a very exciting day, and I feel so honored and blessed to have been chosen to speak to you all. People say that graduation is when our journey begins, but I disagree. These past 4 years have been filled with too many adventures for our stories to not have started yet. We've had our first dance, our first FFA week, our first relationship, our first car. We've made some amazing friends, and we have lost some amazing friends. But through it all, we have persevered. Through every triumph and every loss, we kept our heads held high and our eyes alight with determination. We became the heroes of the great adventure that is high school. And we did it together. So no, our journey doesn't begin here. However, this is where it takes a turn. As I said, we've made it this far together, but now we must all break from this shared road onto our own unique paths and continue our stories on our own. And although it's exciting and thrilling, know that it won't be easy. There will be challenges and setbacks and doubts, and there will be moments when none of it feels worth it. And these feelings will be so easy to fall into because we live in a world that tells us our value is subjective, a world that measures our worth by fickle, materialistic standards. But in these moments of hesitation, I urge you to think of this quote from the great Gatsby. Gatsby believed in the green light, in the future that year by year recedes before us. It eluded us then, but that's no matter. Tomorrow, we will run faster, stretch out our arms farther. This quote is so important for us to remember because it reflects the mindset that we all have, that our dreams are within our reach, we just have to push for them a little harder. It reflects the constant, persisting hope that we can't help but have, the fire that burns brightly inside us despite the world's attempts to douse it. We must hold on to this hope, grasp it tightly with both hands, and let it lead us to the idealistic future that currently eludes us. Because I promise you, it will not always elude us. Today is proof of that. This was once the future we yearned for, and our being here is a testament to our determination and perseverance. We made this happen. We utilized every opportunity and made a way for ourselves. We can do whatever we set our minds to, and although it won't come easily, success will always be within reach. So as we are all here today, in this enchantingly bittersweet moment, let us close this chapter of our lives with pride. Let us take this next step forward with our arms open wide for whatever the world throws at us, because we are stronger than any obstacle in our way. We are people of hope. We are people of inherent value. Our success is inevitable because it is defined by our own terms. It doesn't matter what you major in or what school you attend or if you even go to college at all. We are full of glorious potential and we are destined for greatness. Gatsby didn't achieve his dreams because they were born from the unrealistic fantasies of a man stuck in the past. We won't share his fate because our dreams were built from so much more. They were formed through the experiences we had together. They were cultivated by the people and support all around us. And they will become a reality because we are the class of 2021 and we stop at nothing to accomplish the goals we set for ourselves. And on that note, I'd like to share one more quote with you all before I return to my seat, this one by Henry David Thoreau. Go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life you have imagined. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Adam Hatcher, proud principal of Greenwood High School. Superintendent Rob Clayton, Board of Education members, teachers, staff, parents, friends, and most important, graduates, we welcome you to this special occasion. We are honored and pleased that you're here to celebrate the graduating class of 2021. It is with great pride that we present you 258 seniors representing the 2021 graduating class of Greenwood High School. We realize these graduates are happy and proud of their accomplishments, but we know the parents, grandparents, and guardians of these seniors are just as proud. Would the parents, guardians, grandparents of the 2021 graduates please stand and be honored for their help, support, and dedication given to these young adults. Thank you. I would like to introduce the platform guest at this time. Please stand when your name is called, and please hold all your applause until the platform guests have been introduced. Board members, Mr. Kerry Young, Chairman, Mr. Gary Chapman, Vice Chairman, Ms. Amy Duvall, Mr. Kevin Jackson, Mr. Lloyd Williford, Central Office Personnel, Mr. Rob Clayton, Superintendent, Warren County Public Schools. Mr. Jason Cupcella, Assistant Superintendent, Chief Operations Officer. Dr. Laura Hudson, Director of Instruction for Secondary Schools. Mr. Kyle Cassidy, Director of Principal Leadership. Greenwood Administrators, Mr. Dan Dillingham, Assistant Principal. Ms. Melinda Logic, Assistant Principal. Mr. Dale Wicks, Assistant Principal. Also in attendance are Greenwood's feeder school principals. Ms. Palitha Butts, Alverton Elementary. Ms. Lori Morris, Briarwood Elementary. Dr. Wes Cottingham, Cumberland Trace Elementary. Mr. Matt Thornhill, Natcher Elementary. And Mr. Darrell Woods, Drake's Creek Middle School. Thank you. You may be seated. The senior counselors who have worked directly with the senior class have been a major force behind the graduation process of the class of 2021 are Ms. Casey Board, Ms. Leanne Freeman, and Ms. Candace Jaggers. There are other individuals in the guidance office and administrative office who deserve recognition. Jenny Basham, Gretchen Bush, Melanie Crabtree, and Jennifer Wallace. Their dedication and help enable many activities at GHS to run smoothly. They are valuable members of the GHS team. Playing a large part of the lives of these graduates during their years at GHS have been the teachers and staff of Greenwood High School. Would these individuals please stand and be recognized? Thank you. At this time, we would like to recognize and welcome all former Greenwood graduates. Please stand. Thank you. At this time, we would also like to recognize and welcome all who have served in the military and any students who are going to the military. Please stand. Thank you. We would also like to recognize the GHS senior choir members, Ms. Abigail Sells, and the GHS JROTC Color Guard, Chief Greg Blakeman, for their roles in the graduation ceremony today. Please stand. The class of 2021 will graduate 274 students today. Over 42% of the graduates have been awarded one or more scholarships. To date, the graduates of the class of 2021 have been awarded approximately $5.2 million in scholarship monies. If you are a scholarship recipient, please stand at this time. Thank you. At this time, I would like to recognize some of the accomplishments of this year's graduating class. I will be calling several groups of students, so if you will please hold your applause until all names have been called. The College Board recognizes the many high school students who have distinguished themselves academically by announcing AP Award recipients. A student can qualify for an AP Scholar Award by completing three or more AP exams with a grade of 3 or higher. This class had 20 students that met that criteria. Please stand when your name is called. Emily Arnold, Chase Bailey, Allison Bush, Jacob Condiff, Jenna Criswell, Sophia Del Rey, Leslie Hale, Zane Ahmed, Zaya Tot, David Minotti, Abigail Orr, Callie Ohm, Nan Patel, Needy P. Patel, Kennedy Roberts, Haley Stroutman, Shelby Sutton, Preston Thornton, Bhavna Yadav, and Emma Young. Thank Thank you. A student can qualify for an AP Scholar with Honor Award by receiving an average score of at least a 3.25 on all AP exams, and scores of 3 or higher or 4 or more of these exams. This class had 9 students that met this criteria. Please stand when your name is called. Evan Brittenham, James Chin, Seth Flickinger, Larissa Frisbee, Taryn Geyer, Savannah Hardis, Needy Patel, Luke Shords, and Leah Witcher. Thank you. A student can qualify for an AP Scholar with Distinction Award by receiving at least a 3.5 on all AP exams taken and scores of 3 or higher on 5 or more of these exams. This class had 5 students to meet that criteria. Please stand when your name is called. Eden Casebeer, Samuel McNabb, Pujan Panzeria, Matias Rodriguez-Vaz, Monica Schwinder, and Callie Strode. Thank you. National AP Scholar is granted to students in the United States who receive an average score of at least 4 on all AP exams taken, and scores of 4 higher on 8 or more of these exams. We have 1 student who has earned this award. Pujan Panzeria, please stand. Thank you. The class of 2021 also had 10 students who were selected as Governor Scholars. These students were selected to participate in a 5-week summer program and are identified as top academic students in the state. Please stand when your name is called. Chase Bailey, Allison Bush, Eden Casebeer, Samuel McNabb, Pujan Panzeria, Nan Patel, Needy Patel, Monica Schwinder, Callie Strode, and Leah Witcher. Thank you. Governor School of the Arts is a highly competitive summer program that requires students to audition in areas of architecture, creative writing, dance, drama, instrumental music, musical theater, new media, visual arts, and vocal music. This class had 5 students who were selected as Governor School of the Arts program: Matthew Bird, Logan Harris, Abby Murphy, Callie Ohm, and Vincent Tenero. Thank you. The Commonwealth Honors Academy is an exciting, challenging academic enrichment program for outstanding high school students who have completed their junior year. It has welcomed over 1,700 students to learn, live, and grow on Murray State's campus. This class had 2 students selected for Commonwealth Honors Academy: Leslie Hale, Bhavna Yadav. Thank you. While top priority is placed on academics at Greenwood High School, we also encourage students to become involved in the school and community service. Greenwood High School has two clubs that students can be invited and inducted into, which to focus on the principles of academic performance and service. The following students were invited and inducted into the Beta Club. These individuals had to maintain a GPA of 3.25 and serve at least 50 hours of community service. These individuals could never make a grade lower than a C. These individuals will be identified by the beta symbol they wear on their honor sash. Would all beta members stand and be recognized at this time? Thank you. The next group of individuals that will be recognized had to maintain a minimum of a 3.65 GPA and are required to serve at least 15 hours of community service to fulfill their National Honor Society obligations. NHS members are identified by the yellow and blue cords they wear around their neck. Each one of these stellar students is committed to helping others through community service. Would all NHS members please stand and be recognized? Thank you. We would like to recognize the top academic seniors from the class of 2021. These students are ranked as of the very last day of the school year. These rankings are obtained by using a weighted grading average received from various advanced placement classes offered at Greenwood High School. Would you please stand when your name is called and remain standing? Number 10, with a GPA of 4.273, Callie Strode. Number 9, with a GPA of 4.289, Matias Rodriguez Voss. Number 8, with a GPA of 4.328, Allison Bush. Tied at number 6 with a GPA of 4.346, Eden K. Spear. And Leah Witcher. Number 5 with a GPA of 4.380, Samuel McNabb. Number 4 with a GPA of 4.408, Nan Patel. Number 3 with a GPA of 4.438, Niti Patel. Number 2 with a GPA of 4.443, Pujan Panzeria. And number 1 with a GPA of 4.476, Monica Schwinder. Thank you. We also use a regular grade point average system without using weighted from AP classes. This year we had 20 students who are tied with a perfect 4.0. Would these students please stand when your name is called? Chase Bailey, Abigail Bolin, Kylie Brees, Allison Bush, Eden K. Spear, Rachel Evans, John Mattinson, Samuel McNabb, Nathan Oliver, Abigail Orr, Kaylee Mason Owens, Ashley Parks, Niti Patel, Matias Rodriguez Bass, Monica Schwinder, Callie Strode, Evelina Thornhill, and Leah Witcher. Thank you. This year's class also had 105 students, or 38% of the senior class, designated as honor graduates. These honor graduates have received an honor sash for their achievement. These students have obtained a GPA of 3.5 or higher during their 4 years at Greenwood High School. Would all the honor graduates please stand and be recognized for your hard work and dedication? Thank you. This year's class also had 177, or 64% of students that have a GPA of 3.0 or better. This is an outstanding group of students who have worked very hard to achieve this milestone in their high school careers. The following students will be in the military after graduation. We are proud of their accomplishments and their commitment to service. Please stand when your name is called. Logan Hendricks, Army National Guard. Zatu, Army National Guard. Samuel Humble, Army National Guard. Matthew Royal, Army. Trey Salvador, Navy. And Benjamin Webb Boniker, Army National Guard. Thank you. Beginning their junior year, students at Greenwood High School have the opportunity to take several dual credit classes. These classes are offered through WKU, Sky, Murray State, and Camelsville. Dual credit classes allow high school students to receive both high school and college credit while attending Greenwood High School. Would all the seniors who took dual credit classes please stand at this time? Thank you. Each year, we are preparing our students to be career and college ready. Students can become career and college ready by meeting benchmarks on the ACT, EOP exam, taking and passing qualifying dual credit courses, or receiving other industry certifications. As of May 18th, 214 seniors are career and college ready. They are wearing a transition-ready zipper pull. Would all seniors who have met this benchmark please stand at this time? Thank you. I want to start by just saying congratulations to all of you. You did it. I know that today is one of those milestones in your young lives, and it's one of the most important milestones in your young life thus far. There's a lot of excitement as you look forward to what lies ahead, and I hope there will always be a special place at Greenwood in your heart. You have come to this place today on a pathway that is unique for each of you. For some, that path has been smooth. For others, it has been more challenging. But no matter the path you've traveled, it has all led you to the same destination today. You have earned the right and the privilege of receiving your high school diploma from Greenwood High School. In just a few moments, you will walk across this stage and receive a diploma that you've worked so hard for and have anxiously awaited to receive. I want you to know that I am very proud of each and every one of you. And I know those assembled today are proud of you too. I intentionally will not spend much time discussing the pandemic or how it impacted your senior and junior year, because you have handled it with grace. When all this started your junior year, we did not know what the future would hold. Your perseverance and determination is inspiring. You have masterfully navigated one of the most difficult times in our nation. Am I surprised? No. I would take this group of young adults with me every time. We are all proud of the impact that the class of 2021 has had at Greenwood High School. During your tenure at Greenwood, there have been numerous accomplishments and achievements. Greenwood has a rich tradition of excellence academically, as well as extracurricular and co-curricular programs. Many of you have participated in clubs, athletic teams, band, music, art programs, all the clubs and organizations that a school might offer. Might I add that Greenwood has by far the best student section and by far the best musical in the Commonwealth. I will admit you made me nervous a few times at events over the years, but we made it through it. All of these memories and opportunities that many of you have taken advantage of, I know they've been valuable learning experiences that have helped shape the person you are today. As you move on with life after today, I hope you look back at your time at Greenwood High School and you feel a great sense of pride and accomplishment. I know you appreciate the efforts of your teachers, staff, and parents, as I know they have given much effort to help you reach your goals, and they certainly want you to have success in the future. As you transition today from GHS seniors to GHS alumnus, I hope Greenwood High School has prepared to make whatever dreams come true that you wish. On behalf of everyone here today, we support you. I want you to know that we are very proud of you. We love you, and we wish you the very best. I will leave you with a statement that you hear every morning and afternoon on the announcements. Be good to yourself and be good to others. Later, Gators. Seniors, best of luck and God bless you.
Please excuse this announcement. If anyone has seen Neela Mukanovich, a little girl has a pink shirt on, flowers in her hair, Converse black leggings. She is missing, and we need to get her down here to the officers, or if you've seen her, please get her down to the floor.
Would Mr. Clayton and the board members please stand and come forward? These members of the 2021 class of Greenwood High School have met all graduation requirements of Greenwood High School, the Warren County Board of Education, and the Kentucky State Department of Education. I take great pride in presenting them to you as they come forward to receive their diplomas. To help ensure the dignity of this monumental event in their lives, I ask that you politely hold your applause until each row returns to their seats after they receive their diplomas. Row one, please stand and come forward. Hunter Felton Adams. Alton Ademi. Sueb Altabe. Gabriel Miguel Alfaro. Lillian Marie Allspa. Diana Lene Ankrum. Emily Nicole Arnold. Marissa Blade Arnold. Chase Nicole Bailey. Dylan Thomas Bankhead. Briley Lee Barnett. Stephanie Barrera. Jesus Alexis Baron Garcia. Wesley Allen Bennett. Lindsay Blake. Felix Kipp. Row two, please stand and come forward. Honest Danae Blewett. Anna Kim. Abigail Faith Bolin. Kylie Austin Brees. Seth Allen Brooks. Matthew Hunter Brown. Laurel Catherine Brumley. Isaac Ellis Bunch. Ethan Todd Alexander Burden. Allison Elizabeth Bush. Matthew Benjamin Bird. Talia Nicole Bird. Cole Thomas Carroll. Eden Blair Casebeer. James Chin. Mon Day Singh. Would row three please stand and come forward? Meredith May Clack. Samuel Ethan Combs. Jacob Alexander Condiff. Sebastian Lopez Conwell. Braden Robert Coates. Kaylee Beth Copas. Gloria Costetti. Riley Ann Danielle Crabtree. Dakota Allen Crick. Jenna Nicole Criswell. Brandon Jeremy Cunning. Emra Kuterik. Samuel Wayne Davis. Nixon De Leon. Sophia Ion Del Rey. Chase Andrew Denning. Would row four please stand and come forward? Eliza Tanaya Dodge. Kaylee Marie Dobert. Lin Kwa Dong. Margaret Doherty. Delaney Faith Duncan. Ethan Alexander Dunnigan. Anderson Duran Alvarado. Evan Bruce Ellison. Rachel Elizabeth Evans. Fridin Faisaloo. Kaylee Renee Fields. Donald Bryce Figley. Joki Isis Cheyenne Zay Fitz. Seth Fleckinger. Wesley Tyler Flowers. Mason Thomas Frazier. Would row five please stand and come forward? Larissa Lynn Frisbee. Eddie Fuentes. Braxton Charles Garner. Caitlin Alexander Gardner. Yuwa Hae Gay. Catherine Rose Gibson. Ethan James Goad. Jacob Charles Goodman. Brooklyn Orion Goodrich. Haley Madison Gordon. Jonathan Daniel Gornick. Marcus Grant. Kaya Brielle Gunn. Taryn Lene Geyer. Yamate Hagawara. Nirma Halsik. Would row six please stand and come forward? Leslie Hale. Zane Hamad. Alexandra Bree Hank. Kendra Ann Hansen. Brianna Diane Harden. Logan Harris. Savannah Renee Hardis. Jamari Navante Haskins. Aung San Suu Mitt Hang. Aaron Leah Heltzley. Logan Alexander Hendrick. Elizabeth Jolene Herman. Lori Ann Hewlett. Tyler Reed Hines. Catherine Elizabeth Howard. Zaya Min Teet. Would row 7 please stand and come forward?
Ja Ree Tu. Se Ka Tu. Madison Lee Hughes. Gerald Joseph Huey. Parker Devin Houston. Samuel Carter Humble. Allie Michelle Hunt. Logan Matthew Hunt. Cole Bryant Jackson. Jacqueline Maxine Renee Jackson. Ijek. Leah Mercedes Jernigan. Caleb Michael Jewett. Sydney Nicole Cown. Vun Tae Kim. Savannah Grace King. Would row 8 please stand and come forward? Autumn Kate Kirby. Morgan Riley Krieger. Christopher Aries Orion Lassiter. Larry Latimer. Simeon LaCruz. Carter Jacob Lewis. Ija Lee. Mamars Ian Lipai. Ellen Grace Longest. Luis Fernando Luna Marin. Katie Grace Marr. John Howard Madison. Wesley Philip Matthews. Brianna McCrady. Lydia Dawn McGregor. Samuel Isaac McNabb. Would row 9 please stand and come forward? Zoe Grace McNeely. Trinity Isabel McPherson. Lou May. Mime. Name. Some. Nicole Candace May Milam. Madison Elizabeth Miller. David Mario Minotti. Jeremiah Amir Mitchell. Haley Lorraine Motes. Madeline Brooke Moore. Olivia Nicole Moore. Kevin Marino. Madison Grace Merle. John Cinder Morrison, Jr. Would row 10 please stand and come forward? Jackson Parker Moss. Abby McNeil Murphy. Cameron Neighbors. We Win. Sabrina V. Okra Minko. Katia Oldham. Nathan Linus Oliver. Chloe Nicole Aller. Abigail Lauren Orr. Madeline Lee Osborne. Kaylee Michelle Ohm. Mason Scott Owens. Haley May Page. Sarah Lynn Palmer. Pujan Pansaria. Ashley Marie Parks. Would row 11 please stand and come forward? Essie Parrott. Janice Posich. Nun Patel. Needy Patel. Needy Patel. Dermot Troy Cenares Pinos. Jordan Tanner Ray Persinger. Laura Marie Peters. Jackson Bailey Petty. Tong Pyong. Haley Delaney Isabella Pippen. Kevin Brian Pocasangre. Katarina Popovich. Lo Pao. William Thomas Price. Caleb Cody Prophet. Would row 12 please stand and come forward?
Lily Grace Rayburn. Riley Ann Reno. Lou Ray. Paul Ray. Michael Stephen Rindell. Cameron James Ray. Kyle Riney. Julian Brock Rivera. Kennedy Ruth Roberts. Dalton Japer Roddy. Mateus Rodriguez Boz. Elena Lorraine Raleigh. McKinnon Royal. Bryce Chandler Russell. Lance Montgomery Saltz. Would row 13 please stand and come forward? Amaya Dosco Salvador. Trey Alexander Salvador. Abigail May Sanburn. Justin Paul Sanders. Connor Thomas Shear. Monica Catherine Swinder. Parker Bernard Scott. Neozima Celestino. Landon O'Brien Sells. Luke Benjamin Shorts. William Rashad Simmons. Bragg Peyton Swingler Wicks. Caitlin Brianna Smith. Natalie Grace Smith. Haley Beth Stroutman. Callie Joe Strode. Would row 14 please stand and come forward? Shelby Abigail Sutton. Laura Lee Francis Swincher. DJ Tally. Vincent Tenero. David Taylor. Yeah. Ong Thang. Joshua Scott Thomas. Evelina Ruth Thornhill. Preston Cade Thornton. Tun Tin Thim. Ro Ne Thong. Job Alejandro Torres. Marcus Tyrell Trussell. Thang De Tong. Jonathan Turner. Gage Crawford Turner. Would row 15 please stand and come forward? Kelsey Brianne Upchurch. Zachary Paul Upright. Michaela Amelia Van Wick. Webb Boniker. Isabella Nicole Vargas. Autumn Lynn Vasquez. Jaden Sobin Bone. Mu Ma Wa. Olivia Danae Walker. Kerrigan Dior Watson. Tasha Nicole Watt. Campbell Olivia Welch. David Eugene Weldon. Aaron Michelle Wheeler. Kennedy Danielle White. Gabrielle Lee Wilkerson. Would row 16 please stand and come forward? Carson Blake Wilgruber. Kenneth John Williams. Carrie Lynn Williams. Michaela Williams. Carter Willis. Caitlin Renee Wilson. Maya Rose Victoria Wilson. Raven Lee Wiseman. Leah Faye Witcher. Billy Wood. TJ Wood. Madeline Grace Woodcock. Jacody Lee Allen Wright. Pavna Yadav. Gavin Charles Yan. Emma Grace Young. Anne Elizabeth Zollner. Sang Zuala. Felix Kipp. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Hey guys, I'm gonna talk to you all for a little bit. So you guys may know me as the theater girl. You may know me as the girl who literally never stops talking, like ever, which is true. You may know me as the girl who her sophomore year sang Baby It's Cold Outside in an elf costume in front of the entire school at a Christmas pep rally. Not one of my proudest moments, but it happened. But for those that I'm standing in front of today, I hope you all know me as the girl who loves and cares for each and every one of you. Whether we talk every day or we just say hi in the hallway, I want you to know that these past 4 years with you have been way more than I could have ever expected. Now, for some of us, we've spent the past 4 years of our lives here. And for others, maybe we moved here just this year. But even so, there's no greater feeling than walking into an atmosphere that feels like home. So let's turn back the clock and allow yourself to see how far you've come, where you are now, and where you will be. Freshman year. I don't know about you guys, but I can still remember the feeling of walking into my first period class. Butterflies were literally swarming in my stomach. And I'm sure that I wasn't the only one, but as I looked around, everyone seemed so calm. I don't know how you guys did it, honestly. I was a nervous wreck, and I could not hide it. But I remember looking over at Haley Gordon, who was sitting right next to me, and I was thinking, how is she so chill? I need to take notes from her. Little did we know that 3 years later, we would be leading the student council together. Sophomore year, things began to get more comfortable, and we started to realize what we were passionate about. Friends started to become family. We started to learn to drive, and some of us got our driver's license. Some of us got our driver's license last week. It's a song. All right, tough crowd. Anyways. One thing that stuck out to me sophomore year, and I think a lot of us can relate to that, is AP World. Boy, was that class something. From Deadliest Warrior to ERQs to tears and laughter, that class, like many others, was one of the first experiences where I realized that our classmates can come together and help each other whenever we feel like the stress is too much for us to handle alone. Junior year, pretty much non-existent, but last year was a whirlwind for all of us. Junior year is already known as one of the toughest years for high school students. We start thinking about college, we get jobs, and we gain independence, and we have to start making our own schedules. And don't even mention classes. Honestly, I don't know how Pujan Panseria took so many AP courses, but more power to you, man. University of Pennsylvania is getting a good one. So I'm going to say it. The word that has been creeping its way into our conversations since March 13th, 2020. Corona. In all seriousness, I've never witnessed such determination than what I witnessed when school got canceled. Now, this determination may not have ended up in our online classes, but it did in our lives. I've never tried to convince my mom more of something than when I asked her to go on a social distance trunk car lunch date with the girls. Hey guys, I love you. And now we're here. Senior year. A senior year that we didn't think we would get. A senior year that looked at all of the no's in the face and said, I'll show you. I have mascara on, I cannot be crying right now. The senior year that allowed each of us more freedom to learn who we are before we go out into the big, scary world. The world with scary stuff like moving out and making money and bills. The world is going to offer us things that we most likely don't have planned right now. And that scares me. It scares me because I've created bonds and memories with people who I can be myself around. You guys are my happy place and my comfort zone and my rocks. You guys may not know it, but on days when I felt like there was no light at the end of the tunnel, one of your friendly faces would do something as small as hold the door open. You have no idea how much your actions affect people, even people who seem like they're happy all the time. And teachers and staff, don't think that you go unnoticed in this. You have helped guide our minds for so many years, and for some of us, you're the closest thing that we have to a parental figure. We've cried with you, we've laughed with you, we've danced with you, and we've had some really serious talks with you. We can drive you crazy, we know, but I think I speak for all of us when I say that even if we don't tell you often, you have made a lasting impact on us that we will carry with us forever. Hi, Ms. Spicer. And parents, thank you so much for early morning drives to school, picking us up at late practices, bringing stuff to school whenever we forget, and going through that horrible car rider line. I am so sorry for all of you that had to do that. Okay, guys, this is it. We're here. Look around. Look at how far you've come and think of all of the memories that you've made. Autumn Kirby's favorite memory was when she made 2 points in the Lady Gators senior basketball game. Ann Zollner's favorite memory was being the Gator mascot at the games. And if you didn't know it was her, surprise! Matthew Bird's favorite memory was participating in Greenwood musicals and, of course, meeting Miss Sells. Angelina Santos's favorite memory is choir class. Allie Bush's favorite memory was her first varsity win against South Warren her freshman year. Ashley Parks' favorite memory is Greenwood Formals, put on by yours truly, Student Council. Janice Pasick's favorite memory was when Ms. Spicer said that yellow was his color. Abby Orr's favorite memory was meeting new people. Kat Popovich's favorite memory is winning state for soccer. Kate Thornton's favorite memory was going to big football games. Anderson Duran's favorite memory was Mr. Holder's pre-cal class, and he got to sit next to a pretty cool girl in that class. Nixon DeLeon's favorite memory was lunch. It's a good one. My favorite memory? Definitely when Mr. Dillingham let us eat outside 2 months ago, because I really had to fight for that one. So, in all honesty, my favorite memory has been you guys. And no, I'm not just saying that because I'm standing up here and I have to sound all inspirational, even though it does sound really inspirational. So. In all honesty, you guys are the glue that holds Greenwood together. You're the spirit of Greenwood, and I pray that each and every one of us chooses to follow whatever our hearts are telling us. God has such big plans for each and every one of you and a path that he has perfectly designed for us. So do what you can to trust that. Do what you can to serve others. And do what you can to love yourself, because me and God love you all sure a heck of a lot. Be amazed of the person that you were, the person that you are, and the person that you will be. Be proud of all your accomplishments. Be able to push yourself to do things that you never thought you could do. Be able to push yourself outside of your comfort zone. But most importantly, be good to yourselves and be good to others. Later, Gators. Would the graduating class of 2021 please stand? Oh my gosh. Graduates, please move your tassels to the left. I proudly present the Greenwood High School class of 2021.